It's a face. That's what we see. It is you. It's what you present to the world. It's how you interact with people, how they respond to you. And so a facial disability affects not only the form of the face, it impacts your social as well as emotional quality of life. And in the case of the facial paralysis patients, not being able to show any emotions on your face, it means that people are thinking, why isn't this person smiling or showing some sort of response to what I may be doing? And that's very difficult. Our research question is to understand how the individual is affected by their facial disability. We have developed three-dimensional measures for emotional responses, emotional cues that we do in everyday life, smiling, pursing our lips, puffing our cheeks out. It's hard to standardize these smiles, so there's wide variation in people's expressions. And so we're collecting a large database of people against which to compare these different populations with facial disability, even though there's a wide variation. And then we have other measures we use. What's key here is the way we combine these measures together with the physician's and clinician's assessment to give them a more comprehensive and hopefully a more sensitive treatment planning aid. We hope all of this will improve the patient's overall quality of life, and that's what we're doing here.